Welcome to LR Lakshmi's channel. Please do watch, like and share my videos and subscribe my channel so that you will get the latest notification of my videos. And today video is about attitude, is attitude chapter of 10th class English. And we will start in this video the continuation of this chapter where we have stopped in the last video. It is page number 5, dear viewers. Let us go to the paragraph where we have stopped. He moved to Los Angeles in 2007 and planned to continue to travel the world. In 2009, he visited South America and Middle East. In 2008, Kanai Miyahara, a beautiful young girl whose mother was a Mexican and whose father was a Japanese, attended to a meeting where Nick was the guest speaker in Texas. Let us go in detail to this few lines, children. He moved to Los Angeles in 2007. He moved to Los Angeles. Who moved to Los Angeles? Nick Vujicic moved to Los Angeles and planned to continue to travel the world. He also planned to continue to travel the world as a motivational speaker. In this event, we will go to see the next event. In 2009, he visited South America and Middle East. He not only visited South America, he also visited Middle East in 2009. In 2008, it's an important incident which took place, which was a part of his life. Let us see. Kanai Miyahara, a girl, a beautiful young girl named Kanai Miyahara, whose mother was a Mexican and whose father was a Japanese. The Kanai Miyahara's mother was a Mexican and his father was a, her father was a Japanese, attended to a meeting where Nick was a guest speaker in Texas. Nick in 2008, he attended a meeting in the place of Texas. In that meeting, she, the beautiful young girl also, also attended the meeting where Nick Vujicic was a guest speaker. Kanai was attracted to Nick's message. Kanai Miyahara was attracted to Nick's message. And let us go to the next page, children. From that time, they were in touch with each other to share their ideas on giving hope to needy, and they became close friends. From that time onwards, as they got into each other and introduced their own feelings, these two guys, Kanai Miyahara and Nick Vujicic, were touching each other. That is, they talked, they had a meeting, they were in touch with each other to share their ideas and giving hope to the needy. Here, needy, one who are in help. The needy means, the meaning of needy is one who are in help. Either it is about, that means if someone who is in very distress or any help needy, the meaning of. So these people were in touch and helped the needy people. Who are the people who made in touch each other? Kanai Miyahara and as well as Nick Vujicic, and they became close friends. Who became close friends? Kanai Miyahara as well as Nick Vujicic became close friends. Finally, they fell in love and their engagement happened in August 2011. Finally, these both got into love and also they were engaged in the year of 2011. Nick put the engagement ring on Kanai's finger with his mouth and then said the beautiful words every girl wants to hear coming out from her man's mouth, "Baby, I love you." Here, finally, they both got into love and they were engaged in 2011 and the engagement. At the engagement time, Nick put in the engagement time, they have to put the finger on one's own beloved partner. So Nick, as he was a torso, he put the finger into Kanai's finger, ring into Kanai's finger with his mouth. And Kanai's finger with his mouth and then said the most beautiful words. What a girl needs, the girl, any girl or a man needs some beautiful lines about their loved ones speaking to them. So these beautiful words it seems wants to hear coming out her man's mouth was, "Baby, I love you." Here Nick Vujicic expressed his love after putting the finger with his mouth to can his finger on the engagement day, which took place in 2011. Nick, let us go into the move into the next paragraph. Nick and Kanai got married on February 12, 2012 and on February 13, 2013. They were blessed with a baby of a healthy baby boy with full body. Nick and Kanai, after the engagement, the next incident is they have to become a couple. So they married on February 12th in the year of 2012, and on February 13, 2013, look there, incident which it is as it is according to the fate. Even one can get married by according to the date deciding, but even they were blessed with a young boy. 2000, look children, February 12, 2012 they got married, and February 13, 2013 they were blessed with a boy who was very healthy, blessed with the birth of a healthy baby boy with full body. That means full body, not like torso. Here he may not ask you or he may ask you, that is not the thing, but the incident, you can see the number magic in this incident. These both got married February 12, 2012, and they were blessed with a baby boy, a healthy boy, in February 13, 2013. Let us go have this silly event, that this is some number magic, you can see this. So this is how they got married, how they got engaged, how they got married, and how they were blessed with a young baby boy with a healthy, all his body as usual, like all the people, not like Nick Vujicic. They were very happy with this incident. And let us move into the next paragraph. Hope you that understood this part. Nick and Kanai wrote an inspirational book, Love Without Limits, together, and it was published in 2012. These both, the Nick as well as Kanai, even wrote an inspirational book. The name of the book is Love Without Limits. The Love Without Limits. Look children, Love Without Limits is the book written by Kanai Miyahara as well as Nick Vujicic. It is an inspirational book. What was the book named? The book is named as Love Without Limits, and it was published in 2014. After writing the book, it has to be published, so it was published in 2014. Let us move into the next paragraph. If I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? The human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? Said Nick. Let us go into the paragraph, which is very detailed, in a detailed manner. These are the few quotes which are given by Nick Vujicic, and very interesting and very inspiring even. Look, Vujicic has spoke like, if I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? It's a question for all the viewers, of all the audience, or of all the, even one who hears his quotes. Even though I am a disabled person, if I fail, I try again and again and again till I succeed. Are you going to try again and again if you fail? Yes, we have to try again and again till we succeed. Is that the motivational speaker, what Nick Vujicic made us to be, in a courageous, very bold, not giving up as he has done so. Even what about us having those all strengths? And the human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. The human spirit, the human strength even can handle much worse. As you get the worst situation, you have to handle them, not to run away from the situation. So when you handle them, definitely, obviously, you will lead to success point. So the human spirit has such a strength that they can handle the most, the much more worst worse situation than they can realize. We can realize. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? Said Nick. It matters how you are going to finish. That means it tells you that it matters how you are going to finish, how you are going to face the situation very strong, not giving up. Are you going to finish strong? Yes, we have to finish strong. We have to be bold. We have to give. We should not give up. We should try again and again. It doesn't matter how hard the situation is. Why? Because the human spirit has such a strength to face it. Hope that you understood this paragraph. Let's move into the next paragraph. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves. He said, if I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. As Nick Vujicic quotes are very inspiring, let us see here. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall, when they have difficult, when they face difficult situation. I tell people to keep on getting up, to keep on facing and winning those situations, not giving up. And to always love themselves, As Nick Vujicic, we have discussed in the earlier paragraph, before paragraph that, I am very thankful that the beauty of mind will not be taken. Even he is a torso, even though he doesn't have hands and legs also, the limbs. But he is very thankful to God and he tells that, the people who look at me will not take the beauty of my eyes. That means he tells you to love one's own self, what you are having, what you are blessed with. We have to love one's own self, not hate that I don't have strength, I'm not intelligent, I don't have courage, I don't have memory, something excuses of facing the situation. And he said, who said? Nick Vujicic said, if I can encourage, look children, if I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. He is thinking that if I can encourage even one person in this life, my job is done. I am very thankful. I am very satisfied. Even I am a speaker. I move about all over the world as a motivational speaker to one place and another and give motivational speeches. If one listen to me and one change by my words, my job is done and I am succeeded. I think that I am succeeded. And we also should take this motivational speeches into mind and transform into positive attitude, children. Why can't we? Can you? Yes, we can. So we are listening to the great powerful person of Nick Vujicic, the whole thing, what he has faced from the childhood till now. Even now he's covering all over the world as a motivational speaker. So the last line he tells that, if I can encourage even one person in my life, my work is done. That means even I am satisfied, what I am roaming is completely fulfilled. He's not giving up his, he is going, he being a torso, he is a motivational speaker. Hope that you viewers understood the whole chapter. This is the whole chapter we have discussed in the all the videos, and this is the last video of this chapter, children. Attitude is altitude. It is about the powerful person Nick Vujicic, who was a torso, who led his life from his childhood till now, how he has transformed himself into a motivational speaker, as well as getting married to a beautiful young lady and blessing with a healthy baby boy. He wrote a inspirational book, both of them, the Kanai Miyahara, as well as Nick Vujicic wrote an inspirational book. The book name is Love Without Limits. And finally he tells that if I encourage one man in the life, my job is finished. I would be satisfied is the whole thing which we have discussed in this chapter. Hope you understood this chapter, viewers, and thank you for watching my video.